a slip knot and chain 101. Next, since we usually work into these loops, but this time around we are going to work into these loops that are at the back here. So we need to flip our chain like this, and these loops they have to face down like this. So we are going to work into these loops that are at the back. So to begin, make a double crochet into the second chain from the hook, but into the back loop there. Make a single crochet into that same chain. Skip one chain and make double crochet into the next chain. And a single crochet into that same chain. And just repeat that all the way until the end. Chain 1 and turn your work. For the next row, we are going to do the same thing. So just make a double crochet into this first stitch from the hook. Do not skip this next stitch, just make another double crochet in there and a single crochet into that same chain, same stitch. Skip the next stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch and a single crochet, and just repeat that all the way until the end. Make a double crochet into this last stitch, chain 1 and turn your work. For the next row, we are going to repeat the previous row. Just make a double crochet into this very first stitch from the hook and do the same thing you have done for the other side, this side. So which means do not skip any chain, just make a double crochet into this next stitch and a single crochet. Skip one stitch, double crochet and a single crochet into the next stitch. Repeat that until your project measures about 8 inches long. Double crochet into the first stitch from the hook. Skip the next stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch and a single crochet into that same stitch, and just repeat that by making double crochet and a single crochet into one stitch after you have skipped one, which is actually everything is going to be done in the single crochet stitch. Which means always this stitch that you are skipping is the double crochet stitch, and the one you will be working in it's the single crochet stitch that you have just made. This is how your work must be looking like. So just repeat that until your project measures about 8 inches long this way. Okay, we are done with the first part. Now the second part, we are going to form the triangle part, which is going to cover our belly part, and it's going to be in a V shape or triangle, but I prefer, yeah, if it's a triangle then it has to be like this, but you have just to keep on decreasing until it forms that deep V. So for the next step, what you're going to do, once you are satisfied with the first part, now just try to count from the end here until the 30th stitch, then mark it, as well as from the other end and mark the 30th stitch. Then we're only going to work in between these marked stitches. Next step, make a slip knot . Insert the hook into this same stitch that you have marked with a stitch marker. Make a slip knot. You can remove the stitch marker because it might disturb you. Just make a double crochet in that same stitch you have made a slip stitch, Make a single crochet into the next stitch, double crochet into the next stitch, and just alternate that all the way until you reach the other stitch, which is this one, as we are only going to work between these two marked stitches. At the end here, just chain one and turn your work as usual. For the next row, we are going to start with decreasing, but we have to stick to our pattern. Since we have ended with a double crochet, which means we are going to start with a single crochet, and in the next stitch where we have previously placed a single crochet, we are going now to make it a double crochet. So now to decrease, just insert the hook into this first stitch from the hook, yarn over, insert the hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, 4 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. So now just continue doing that and do the same thing at the end. I'll meet you at the end to show you the next step. So the last stitch, yarn over, insert the hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, 2 loops on the hook, insert the hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through all 3 loops. That's just what you're going to do for this. So just continue doing the same thing by decreasing the first 2 stitches and the last 2 stitches all the way until your front part forms a deep V. Then I'll meet you once I have made my deep V to show you the next step. Just make a single crochet into this last stitch since it's the only one that's left. Chain one and you can cut off the yarn. And this is how our V shape looks like. For the next step, we are actually now going to work across here, where we are going to place our straps. Or if you are fine with this size, you don't need like to add some more rows here, because the reason I'm saying we are going to work across here is just because it seems to be a little bit small and you need like to add some more rows here to increase the size of the top. But if you are satisfied with the coverage like this, then it's fine. You can just go ahead to make straps, and this whole spaces will be enough to place your straps. So without further ado, let's just make our strap. And for our straps, we are actually going to do it with a different yarn color again. Not this yarn color, not this one, but a different one. For straps, you can still go ahead and use whatever yarn you have at hand, so long as it's a DK yarn. Just make a slip knot and chain whatever number of chains you want. Just make it long enough. At least your chains must be at least 100 or more than that. And we are not going to slip stitch back into the chain or make a single crochet. We are just actually going to leave it so thin like this. But if you want your strap to be a little bit thick, then you can go ahead and slip stitch back into it or make a single crochet back into it. But in my case, I'm just going to chain like this and leave it as a thin strap like this. So for the next step, let's just try to place our strap, because we are done with it, and this is how it looks like. I didn't really count how many chains I have made, but I recommend you to make about more than 100 chains or 100 dot. So just go ahead and place your strap in here. You can place your strap in with a yarn needle to make it more easy for you. Just try to look for spaces. So long as those spaces, they are opposite to each other, just go ahead and do your thing. I wish I could use 2 yarn needles for this. And yeah, we are done with our top. This is how our top looks like. Just go ahead and weave in your ends, and this is how our top looks like. Yeah, we are done. Actually, just a matter of trying to be creative with what you have. Do not try to waste yarns. Just made something wearable out of scrappy yarns. Thank you.